welcome, City Councilman. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
We know that just this past weekend had reports of two Jewish teenagers surrounded by an angry mob with baseball bats in Brooklyn, told to chant Free Palestine before then beating them. The mayor saying today that we're seeing horrible and consistent patterns here. What action is the Jewish caucus going to try to take to stop the attacks?
We need to see the city of New York and our NYPD really standing up for hate crimes. In the Jewish tradition, there's a poem about first they came for. And so we've seen it happening to the Jewish community. We've seen it happening to the Muslim community and the Asian community, the API community. The city needs to step up. We have the most diverse city in the world, and we need to make sure that every community can feel safe. And that means making sure that we really treat every single one of these incidents as the hate crimes that they are, that they're appropriately prosecuted, and that we really expand the education initiatives and bridge our communities here in the city.
And also seeing beefed up patrols in Orthodox neighborhoods as well. Is it enough?
It isn't enough. I represent the Upper East Side, and the only kosher pizza place in the neighborhood across the street where I go to synagogue has been vandalized. This is happening everywhere, and whether you're Jewish, Muslim, or AAPI, people are in fear all over our city, and we really need to make sure that we are doing what we can to support each and every community.
So you do think we need to have a special task force set up, like we've seen against anti-Asian crime as well?
Yes. Anti-Semitism is something that my family left hungry, fleeing, and it's horrifying to see that it's rearing its ugly head right here in New York City.
You know, when we've talked about the Asian community and so many underreported incidents between the communication difference or the fear of retaliation, do you find that's the same thing within the Jewish community?
Absolutely. We've had multiple incidents, whether it's having the menorah that we light as a community defaced multiple years in a row, whether it's having a sukkah, which is a tent we put up during the year, having somebody draw a swastika on it, or even just incidents where people who are Jewish are walking to synagogue and they might be wearing a kippah or a hat or a tallit, a ritual garment, and they'll have incidents with people throwing things at them. And when that happens, when I find out, I'll often reach out to them and say, do you want to press charges? I'll go with you to the police department. Mm-hmm. The community will come together to support you. And quite often people are very grateful for the outreach, but they just don't want to make themselves a target, and they just want to move on with their lives. They don't want to revisit the trauma. So this is happening in the AAPI community. It's happening in the Jewish community. It's happening in every community.
How's your campaign going since we mentioned that you're running for Manhattan Borough President?
We're out there talking to voters, and the big thing that folks are incredibly concerned about is the hate crime and the violence. But folks are really concerned about just being able to afford to stay in the city. Everyone lives here. I've been a lifelong tenant, and I'm really hoping that we can take our city back and make sure that everyone can afford to live here and no one gets forced out.
All right. City Council Member Ben Kalis joining us.